It's 8 a.m. It's time for some Wake Up Missoula. Do you know where your children are at this morning? Well, they should be at school. Today is an interesting day because we have a bunch of those Trump-tastic videos for you guys that a lot of the kids and I have made for you guys during Flagship Fridays. And, of course, we have a very special one in honor of Inauguration Day of Donald John Trump. I didn't even know his name was John. It was just Donald J. Trump for a while. So he'll be inaugurated at 10 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Well, it's noon o'clock over there, so we have about 2 hours left. So today I'll be talking about some news, some weather. I have pre-critic talking about some of the new releases that are coming out. I got some city council. They're talking about the art park and Ward 2 seat filler to fill Harlan Wells as he is moving to Helena for a job. We got Megs, which are covering the Montana Book Festival, and we also have dog training tips, and we have Native Voices on clean water. Made another Trump-tastic video for you guys. There's going to be a lot of nice little short Trump videos that we've made in the last year, for sure. And then, of course, I'll have more on that and more later on. We have events as well. So let's talk about the weather. The weather has been acting pretty weird. That's a nice way of putting it. It was unseasonably warm yesterday. Of course, we always have that dipping up and down from warm to cold. But if we take a look at some of the weather, this is from the forecast.weather.gov. So this is the National Weather Service. We got freezing fog happening. It is 30 degrees outside. It's still warm, but if you guys were walking around downtown, if you guys plan on walking outside, be aware that it is very slippery and you really can't trust yourself even on some of the areas that are that don't even look like they're frozen. So be aware of that. Your high is going to be 36. Your low is going to be 12. It's going to be mostly cloudy. Saturday, you're going to have that chance of snow happening. But yeah, let's talk about some of the slopes and some of the snow. So we have some for your Montana snow reports. I'm just going to go through this. You're going to see me while I talk about it. I got this from onthesnow.com. This Whitefish Mountain Resort, they got 5 inches of snow in the last 72 hours. Blacktail Mountain Ski Area had 1 inch in the last 72 hours. Let's see, Big Sky Resort, they had 1 inch in the last 24 hours, which is on top of their 2 inches in the last 72 hours. Let's see, we got Bridger Bowl is about 2 inches in the last 24 hours. Discovery Ski Area had about 3 inches of snow in the last 72 hours. So it's just warm enough to get the snow in the Missoula Valley area. So if you guys are planning on going up to the slopes and whatnot, a lot of the slopes are open, but you can always call ahead to determine whether or not the slopes are open. And, of course, they probably want your business, so they'll say all the slopes are open. So you guys can check this out by going to onthesnow.com to find out how many of their slopes are open in those ski areas. And moving on, let's talk about some news items. First of all, the Missoula County Attorney's Office released the 2016 report, which highlighted the amount of crime in Missoula based on the following. Felonies were up by 9 from 2015, which marks it at 671 in the Missoula area. Misdemeanors are up by 157. We got juveniles are down by 8 since 2015, but the data doesn't really span further than 2015. Total crime cases in Missoula have gone up from 1,745 to 1,904. On a side note, from 2012 to 2013, felonies went down from 662 to 609. So it's steadily gone up, and it's now kind of back to the average from 2012. Violent crimes have increased by 4%, while property crimes are down 31%. However, drug-related crimes have been rapidly increasing. I saw an 18% increase. Violent crimes are over 60%. Over 60% of violent crimes in Missoula are domestic-related. Sexual crimes have dramatically dropped from 35 days in 2014 to 1 day in 2016. This is also to attribute the special victims unit that kind of got their I guess the word I'm looking for is I got this from the the Missoula County Attorney's Office, and this is their special victims unit in Missoula. Of course, to find out more, and I got these statistics from them as well, you can go to the Missoula County Attorney's website, and also they have a Facebook page that you guys can totally check out. Another news item that's happening in Missoula that's a big news. Since 1984, the Fox site has been barren and empty, and now the city of Missoula is working with developers in agreement to work with them and make it so it can be, I guess... All right, I should actually read my notes rather than trying to come up with it through my head. So the new owners of the Fox site have developed a development agreement highlighting the use of a conference center with the city of Missoula that will be built on the site along with their hotel. It's located between the Taco John's and the beginning of Front Street, just before you get to that parking garage kind of site off of the hospital. A 200-room hotel with 10,000 square feet of meeting space over... I believe, let me just double check this, 29,000 square feet are going to be devoted to the conference center, as well as the project will cost $150 million, with parking being about $40 million. The city of Missoula will make this a tax increment site, which, they'll use a tax increment financing, a TIF funds, get some of that sweet tax money from the hotel buying this space as well. So Missoula has been looking to fill this space since 1984. In national news, at 10 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, President-elect Trump will become 45th President of the United States, Donald John Trump, with a rocky beginnings to rocky media presence, to a rocky primary, to a rocky election. Many common sense folks think that this inauguration will be just as rocky. There's definitely a lot of women's group and a lot of other groups that will be protesting in the designated protesting zone. And from what I saw, just like kind of glimpses on news, is that they had a inauguration concert not too long ago, and it goes just as rocky. So you expect a fairly rocky presidency, whether it's directly related to Trump or indirectly related to Trump. Federal studies, of course, the biggest thing that Congress is taking advantage of when Trump becomes elected is that they are planning on repealing the Affordable Care Act, the media calls Obamacare. The federal study says up to 142,000 Montanans will lose coverage, not to mention millions more across the nation. Next week, the Republican-run House will look at repealing the Affordable Care Act. Democrats ask the folks who are on ACA and who support the ACA should call both parties, write letters, and voice their concerns about the repeal of this. And I did read a story on NPR News saying that 75% of Americans say that they are support of keeping the Affordable Care Act, but I'm trying to think of this because I said this a while ago on the morning show early January, where they were talking about 75% of folks say that. And a good chunk of them are Republican, and they voted, and they don't like the Affordable Care Act, but they'd rather keep something than have nothing. So no replacement is worse than, on the NPR story, sorry, just bear with me, the NPR story said that 75% are with the Affordable Care Act, saying that... Oh man, I'm just like losing it today. but yeah, you just check that out. It's a great story, and they talk about how if the only way that the Affordable Care Act should be gotten rid of is if they find a suitable replacement for it. But as of late, there hasn't been a replacement in sight. So many people, from what I've seen in the news articles as well, is that 11 million Americans have actually signed up since December for the Affordable Care Act as well. And you can find out more information about that by going on to USA Today. And I found NPR.org, and there's a whole bunch of other things as well. And, of course, you've probably been hearing about it all the time, and you don't need to hear anything more about it. Let's talk about... where you can find more information about Wake Up Missoula. You can find out more information about me and see how I stumble over words because I tend to do that a lot, and I've seen some of my old shows, so I'm working on it. You can log on to wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula to find out more information about Wake Up Missoula. We have past video, we have past interviews and past videos all for you guys to check out. We got a bunch of fun, cool little short videos for you guys. Also, you can log on to mcat.org where you can find all your local government videos and more, and of course, local programming made here at MCAT for MCAT. I have a bunch of new programs for you guys, which are highlighting, as I teased before, the Montana Book Festival, the Native Voices. So they were talking about some clean water on the reservations as well. But first, here is a video talking about some tips and tricks on training your dog with all these new media assistance grant program that MCAT provides for nonprofits and organizations here in town, where we go down and film your organization. You can find out more information by going to mcat.org. You can call us at 542-6228. You can also call, the number is also 542-MCAT. You can also email us mcat@mcat.org. But without further ado, here is all the teases of all the new program that will be happening today and this weekend.
Your dog scratching your dog or whatever, and they start to do a bunch of that lip licking, yawning stuff, it's usually because they are either overstimulated or it's causing them discomfort in some way, and they're trying to calm you down. Another really good example is Rover's over here, I'm over here, Rover, come. And, you know, he either completely ignores me or he looks my way and then goes on about his business, right? And I'm a typical dog owner and I'm like, Rover, you're a bad dog, get over here right now, you know? And often what Rover will do is sit down or lie down or begin coming towards me, but very slowly. And typical dog owner that I am, what's the matter with you? You're taking too long. Hurry up, bad dog, rah, rah. And really what's happening there is that the dog is moving toward you slowly or indirectly or offering you that sit or that down as a calming signal because they perceive that you are upset. And also, a quick thing about that come command, I have found that it is a great deal easier to get a dog to follow you or come with you than it is to get a dog to come to you when you are face on and standing still. Because face on, standing still is primate behavior, right? And we're trying to do distance decreasing behavior. Come on, come on, come on, I'm facing you, I'm standing still, but come on, come on, come on. But everything about me is saying don't come closer. And if I get mad because my dog didn't come, that's a whole bunch more stuff that's saying don't come closer.
Hey, Missoula, happy to be here. Okay, I'm gonna read from my new novel, This Side of Providence. It is the story of a mother struggling with addiction who gets put away for a little bit of jail time and her kids get thrown asunder. And the story follows all of them in rotating narrators. I'm gonna read from the landlord slash drug dealer, and his name is Snowman. My eyes are a light blue you wouldn't find in the waters of the Caribbean, not on a black kid from South Providence. Toni Morrison was wrong. I have the bluest eyes. Some people don't know what to do when they see me, so they look away. Others stare at my skin like it's parchment, covered by some ancient text they're trying to figure out. A few come right out and ask me what the hell happened to my face. Those are the ones that I talk to. I don't use the term albino. I don't like it. It makes me think of a lab rat or a genetically modified pit bull some gangster would pay a lot of money to lock in a cage. I've been called dozens of names in my life. Whitey, Casper, Ghost, Spook, Marshmallow, Paper Plate, Rice Man, Milky, Vanilla, Lightbulb, Charmin, Wonder Bread, Ice Cream, Tampon, New Socks, Elmer's, Cotton, Goose, Coconut, Yogurt, Sheets, Cocaine, Sugar, and Salt. But the one I like best, the one I let people call me, is Snowman. It just fits.
On the Crow Reservation as well, so on the Crow, they also have contaminated water systems, but the problem with theirs is a lot of their water systems are that they use for the homes are private wells. So we would need to downscale the, take a bench scale, but make a smaller version of the point of use filter that will be available for in-home use. And so that's what I'm working on. Other than that, I'm trucking along pretty well, and I'm very thankful for the funding that was provided to me through the university, through the Alfred Peace Loan Program, and different NSF opportunities, as well as EPA STAR.
All right, welcome back. And now it's time for some pre-critic. So as you guys know, Vin Diesel is back with another movie about, I guess he's doing a lot of extreme chasing and being trying chased and all sorts of movies and stuff like that. But anyways, let's go from a rating that parents would never let you watch. In this 80s comes, of course, in the 80s, comes a movie experience that continues Vin Diesel's excuse to be in more movies. This is Triple X, as if seeing a bunch of X's would give you thrills. Then why don't you check out the Missoula art, the Red X's, which is just downtown Missoula. More or less thrills than the leading brand, than you've, what you've come to say is, what do the Triple X's stand for? They mean three felonies. If you haven't seen the first movie, forgot about the second movie, and now there's another one. So the first movie was about, oh yeah, Triple X's is like, oh, you got three felonies, Grand Theft Auto, assault, blah blah blah, and it was like, we need you to be like a spy without any kind of like formal training or anything like that. And then they made the movie, and then the sequel was more like, it was, oh look, here's another guy who has another three X's on his program, and now they're bringing two different guys together, Ice Cube and Vin Diesel. I didn't even know Ice Cube was in this movie. It's like the main character is Vin Diesel, because it's the whole Xander Cage is the return, so you guys can totally check that out. Next is, will there be enough time to watch yet another movie by a man who's become synonymous with bad movies? Comes Split, a movie by M. Night Shyamalan. It's about a guy who has split personalities, which kidnaps young girls for some reason, which watch how they interact with this man who's trying really hard to pull out multiple voices in a reasonable amount of time. Expect a twist from visionary director M. Night Shyamalan in this show about who he is, but ask yourself why you're watching this. Up next, we got McDonald's, the movie. The founder, not since the movie Mac and Me, have we seen a product placement movie based around a restaurant that started off as a burger joint and now has basically taken over the world. In terms of getting your food fast, and whether you admit it, whether admit you going to it or not, because there's over billions of people served, you know, you've got to have gone there at least once. Whether you've gone there or not, as a kid, whether you want its chicken nuggets, until they venture off getting food that's not mac and cheese, chicken in round forms, or mini food bites like kids really like, because, you know, that's really what kids only want for the first couple years until they're like, oh, this is not so bad. Taste change. Okay, anyways, this movie has Michael Keaton, who looks like my old band teacher. There's a documentary about this movie you can watch, which covers the same thing, but some people will like drama whether they want it or not. Hence, the founder. That concludes your pre-critic. I have a nice little short video for you guys. Next week, I'll be starting out Teen Talk and some flagship programs from Hellgate High School, but all the flagship programs in the Missoula area will start in February. We'll have more on that later on, but here is Trump Kid starring Tristan from Washington Middle School.
Hi, my name is Tristan, and I will be talking to you about he is amazing, a true patriot. We all think he's amazing and should be our Lord and Savior. He is the master of suspense, the salt of saltiness, the beautiful of God. I'm just gonna build up, and he is the only Donald Trump. As long as I can remember, Don Trepp is my hero. Television's better. He's like the YouTube comment section, negative but true. I'm not afraid to ask the hard questions. Who, maybe what, and sometimes why. There's a lot of people that say Trump isn't a good person, and all I have to say to that is, they're jealous. Hey, we're just jealous. For Trump, winning isn't winning. Winning is winning. Hey, you wanna go out with the guy who loves Donald Trump? Trump is a real icebreaker.
Who are you talking to?
See at Trump O'Clock. I model myself after the great and lord of Trump. Why won't my hair come over like he does? Don't worry, you're beautiful, just like Trump. Wait, who are you? I'm the essence of Trump, the person that you want to be, the person that you know you will be. I think I know who I am. More than I do. Sorry, I should have never doubted you. You're smart, beautiful. You're the most beautiful kid, like Trump. And don't forget it, or you. Or you. Or you.
Hey!
It's hard being a Trump supporter. But for those who don't vote for Trump, I'll build a wall separating the little kids from the big kids. Then make everyone pay a little, except for me. You're just like the U.S. economy. Next page. I'm not here to give problems, only solutions. Which one of you poor people know where the bathroom is? Solution one, Donald. Solution two, Trump. Solution three, Donald Trump. Solution four, repeat solutions one through three. Trump doesn't need money because he already bought your vote. Sometimes I like to go to the zoo. The stairs are for poor people. I like to go up in style. I'm gonna take the elevator. You should come with me since you've been going wherever I go. And to conclude, my conclusion, vote for Trump or you'll be voting for an angry old man or a naggy woman. And vote for Trump because he eats pizza with a fork, which means I eat pizza like a fork. And who doesn't want to be like me or Trump? Vote for Trump and you'll get forked pizza. Look, Donald Trump, no hands. Wait a minute. Walls. Walls everywhere.
Welcome back. As you can see, we made that just before Hillary won the primary against Bernie Sanders, so you kind of get the scope of when we made it back in 2016, when we're all so young. Anyways, moving on, we got some city council stuff for you guys, talking about what's going on in Missoula. Every 4 years, the long-range transportation master plan is updated and improved based on performance-based planning. So it's performance-based planning. It's like planning of a plan, which means building routes and improving existing areas based on things like bus ridership, the amount of foot traffic, bikes, and all that stuff. The public meeting time and place will be available at activatemissoula.com. That also... the same place where you can talk about your woes and complaints on how transportation in Missoula should change to better suit you and your community. Activate Missoula is the website where you can public comment, and they'll be accepting public comments until February 10th. Here is Melissa Morris. She is from the Transportation Planning. She's a Transportation Planning Manager, and she talks about money uses in terms of improving transportation in Missoula.
So at the end, on the pie chart on the right, it reflects the allocation of funds in that scenario four among the just the discretionary. The pie chart on the left, it looks at the total package of funds, so including the funds that are committed to other projects already and the funds that are not touchable, that are non-discretionary. So you can see with the pie chart on the right, when even though we have allocated 37% of our discretionary funds to non-motorized, when you put it in the context of the overall funding picture, 6% is a much lower piece of the pie. That's just an example. So it just goes to show that we have, you know, a relatively modest or minor amount of funds that we have control over at a local level. And so even if you make major shifts in funding towards one category, it doesn't necessarily change the entire picture of how our funds are allocated. And
that's all right. So that was Melissa Morris kind of explaining a little bit more about how the money works in the area. Public comment for the long-range transportation master plan will be open until February 10th. You can comment on activatemissoula.com. Which they will bring up on the TPPC meeting on Tuesday towards the end of, I believe they're going to be doing this in February, late February, once they get all the public comments all kind of constructed and figure it out, and just figure out which areas need improvement, which areas need better transportation, which areas need like ridership and bus travel and all that stuff. So it's the long range transportation planning master plan, and they won't talk about it again for another 4 years, and they also are planning on figuring out funds and which areas are more important. And that was with your public works. Moving on, parks and conservation. On July 25th, 2016, the city of Missoula, following extensive public process, design and fundraising, which is currently at $830,000 by Friends of Missoula Art Museum, and including a $75,000 contribution by Adventure Cycling Association to create an art park on Pine Street. The Missoula Art Park has been a long-time goal of the community, including the Missoula Downtown Master Plan, in order to maximize the public benefit of the art park and also maximize efficiencies of maintenance and management of the park for intended use and users. Approval of both agreements and the approval of permanent encroachments of the art park into the public street right of way. Basically, that all means is that they try to figure out who should take care of those little patches of grass. And with the art park as well, they put a bunch of bike racks, and they even have a working restroom in the art park, which is going to be seasonal. Because most bathrooms in a lot of the parks in Missoula are seasonal as well. Parks and Rec Director Donna Glockler talks about the partnership with Adventure Cycling, which is directly across from the Missoula Art Museum via the art park.
So what we did is, depending, we have a shared agreement with Adventure Cycling. So this is a great example of public nonprofit partnership, where Adventure Cycling has paid $75,000 toward the public improvements. The public right-of-way line is this line right here, the property line. Any irrigation connected to the building, to Adventure Cycling, is Adventure Cycling's responsibility. That's in pink. Any irrigation connected to the museum's irrigation system is park's responsibility. Except, Adventure Cycling will be mowing the turf grass under these areas, as they always have been over here, and then they'll add this little piece right here. The reason for that is one of the things that Parks was trying to do is avoid an additional push mower in running around on a small patch of grass. Adventure Cycling already has responsibilities as it relates to the boulevard ordinance. They're already mowing and maintaining that like you do your residents, and so they'll just pick up this little piece here. Within the agreement, the city will also provide some initial spring help with the beds because, you know, as Adventure Cycling has said, we're not necessarily horticulturists, we're bicyclists. So we'll give them a little bit of spring startup and fall close down on their beds to keep them going and make sure that they're looking the way we all want them to look.
All right, so that's basically the basics on what Adventure Cycling will be doing. Like any other homeowner, people who own areas in which they have right-of-way spaces, you know, like keep your sidewalk clear, maintain your area, kind of like they own that portion of the art park, but at the same time, it's also kind of a mixed ownership. So the Missoula Art Museum, which is leased through the city, so the city basically owns this little art park, and without in like over. I guess what I'm trying to say is that without overreaching the city's authority, they want to work with the business or nonprofit that is Adventure Cycling, so they can maintain the art park, and it's gonna be like a joint maintenance of the art park. So Adventure Cycling will take care of their own, and of course. With the potential idea that maybe Adventure Cycling won't be there forever, like the art park plans on being there for forever, they will rework. There's a contract in place, so if any future owners or future people who go inside where Adventure Cycling is right now, they will be working with the Parks and Rec Department and the City of Missoula to work out a deal in terms of maintenance. So that's what they were basically talking about throughout this particular meeting. And you can find out more information by going on to the Parks and Conservation meeting at ci.missoula.mt.us. Another big thing that was happening is at the Committee of the Whole. The city continues to interview candidates to fill Harlan Wells' Ward 2 seat. It's a long process, and I'll keep you guys updated, and we'll all figure it out as it becomes more and more apparent, and they'll be talking about this during the city council meeting when they will approve the new city council ward filler, which will continue, finish Harlan Wells' term, which he just had it for a year, so they'll have 2 years in Harlan Wells' seat, Ward 2. And so it was a long meeting at the Committee of the Whole, and you guys can check out all the candidates by logging on to ci.missoula.mt.us. And here is their nice little website. But speaking of Art Park and Missoula Art Museum, we have a nice little art clip, which is going to be, which I'll be showing pretty much all of January, and which will be leading up to their art auction. And I believe it's the first Saturday in February where they'll be bringing up these art pieces for anybody to buy their art, and all the money that's raised here, raised at the art auction, will be to benefit the Missoula Art Museum. Free admission, free expression, and of course all their other educational programs at the Missoula Art Museum, which works with kids in the community along with MCPS schools. Thank you. And you can check out all those art pieces at the Missoula Art Museum anytime until February. Moving on, we got some events for you guys. So I'm going to talk about what's happening in and around Missoula for your Friday. Book sale to benefit the Bitterroot Women's Club is going to be at Green Ribbon Books. And join them from 10 a.m. this morning to 6 p.m. for their annual book sale. Missoula Building Industry, Missoula Building Industry Association 2017 Home Show is going to be at the Hilton Garden Inn starting at noon, and also be going on tomorrow as well in case you miss it today. Winter is here, but spring is right around the corner, which makes the perfect time for remodel projects, or maybe it's the year that you're finally going to get the home theater or the beautiful deck you've always wanted. Maybe you are even ready for a brand new house. However, your plans for this year and beyond, the 2017 Missoula Building Industry Association Home Show is the perfect place to make your plans a reality. So if you guys are planning on doing any home improvements, you can figure out a way for things that you can do and other contractors as well that can also expert consultation. This will be going at the Hilton Garden and at 12 p.m. Until 7 p.m. today, and also tomorrow from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And the tickets are $5 a person. Another big thing that's happening, of course, if you saw my interview on Wednesday, thanks again to Shelby Art for coming on my morning show to represent MCT's musical, Urinetown. So the Missoula Community Theater presents Urinetown, the musical. Yes, Urinetown, the musical. Interesting title, but they didn't name it. It is rated PG-13. It's a comedy about public toilets are regulated by mega corporations. You're in good company. So people must pay for the privilege to pee. It's basically based on a drought that's happening in the area. It must be California. And they're doing a play musical about some of the woes that the lower class has to deal with. While also there's a little romance between somebody who doesn't have the money to pay for a toilet while with somebody who has money to pay for the toilet. And you can and this will be playing tonight at 7:30 p.m. All the night shows are at 7:30 p.m. With matinees on Saturdays and Sundays at 2 p.m. Also, Sunday they have an earlier night show at 6:30, and this will be going on until January 29th, I believe, so that you only guys got today all the way until next Sunday to watch Urinetown, the musical at MCT. Here are some of your Missoula Public Library events that are happening in Missoula. You got Tiny Tales of the Missoula Public Library starting at 10:30 a.m. this morning. Family Storytime at 10:30 at the Missoula Public Library. So they're going to be going against each other. So one might be at the Dragon Rug on the top floor of the Missoula Public Library, or they'll be in the large meeting room unless otherwise specified. Watercolor painting class will be at the Missoula Public Library at 12 p.m. Yarns, so it's a knitting group, and you get to learn how to knit or be part of a group that knits and just kind of stitch and talk. Thinking about money, Shred It. It's happening a special event at the Missoula Public Library at 1 p.m. Teen Writers Group, if you're interested in improving your writing skills with constructive criticism, because criticism shouldn't be a negative thing. And it's at 3:30, right after school today, and of course a lot of the high school kids are going through finals week. And this is very geared towards middle school and teens, anybody between in the teen range, basically. Cheap Nate Night is also happening tonight at 7 p.m. at the Missoula Public Library. To inquire what movie will be playing, you can call 721-BOOK. Here are some of your music events that are happening in Missoula. Andrea Harshall will be at the Missoula Brewing Company Highlander Tap Room at 6 p.m. This is just off of Reserve. The Captain Wilson Conspiracy will be at the Montana Distillery. The live music by Andre Floyd will be at 10 Spoon Vineyard Winery. There's Nappy Roots with special guest Keyboy. It's going to be at Monk's tonight at 9 p.m. It's going to be hip-hop. YWCA Inauguration Fundraiser Concert will be at VFW Old Beck, Post 209 tonight. Russ Nassett and the Revelators will be at the Union Club, and 20 Grand will be at the Top Hat Lounge. It's going to be a funk band happening at the Top Hat Lounge. I actually might check that out if I'm not if I'm not already tired and just want to just go home and go to sleep, because sleeping is awesome. Saturday, health-wise, low-cost health screenings will be at Community Medical Center, Community Medical Cancer Center, and they have general health screenings for $20, lipid and glucose screening, $10, vitamin D screening, $20, and of course, during the winter, there are a lot of people who have low vitamin D count because of the lack of sun. 12-hour fast prior to lab draw is required. You may take medications as normal and drink water. No appointment necessary. So you can see flyers for additional details, and this is going to be at Community Medical Center. Winter Storytelling with Stephen Small is happening tomorrow at 11 a.m. at Travelers Rest State Park. Penned O'Rear Elder Stephen Small Salmon is a traditional dancer, singer, and storyteller. He is helping to preserve the Salish language as an instructor at the Institute in Arley. Mr. Small is a favorite presenter at Winter Storytelling. Expect the unexpected as he talks about his life and shares traditional stories of his Salish roots at Travelers Rest State Park, happening tomorrow at 11 a.m. Missoula Art Museum is having an open figure drawing for those who are 18 and up. So you get to draw a nude. It's $10 or $8 for members of the Missoula Art Museum. This is an open drawing session, provides artists the opportunity to draw a form of a live model. Some supplies are available for use. Arrive early for the room fills up quickly. And that's happening tomorrow at 2:45 p.m. Barefoot in the Park is happening at the University of Montana. It is the the Rocky Mountain Repertory Theater is presenting the Neil Simon's work Over the Years. It's fitting for the 50th anniversary of commemoration by the staging of another of his plays. Simon crafts a classic and hilarious romance that reminds audiences that he is a genius of comedy and of the human heart. And that is all your Saturday events. Here are some of your Saturday library events as well. Family Storytime is happening at the Missoula Public Library at 11 a.m. Computer Electronics and the Makerspace is happening. Wait, nope. Nope. The Family Storytime, 11 a.m. and Thinking Money board game event. So I'm assuming they're going to play Monopoly tomorrow at 2. And that's your Saturday events at the Missoula Public Library. Ooh, sorry about that. Dan Henry, the one-man Dan band, is going to be playing at the Imagination Brewing Company tomorrow night at 6 p.m. Patrick McKay, 6 p.m. at Missoula Brewing Company, Highlander Tap Room. Ben Winship, Eli Westhouse Concert. Ooh, that's a long title. It's going to be at John Parker's Church at 7 p.m. And it's acoustic band. Snowflake Ball is happening at Lolo Square and Round Dance Center. It's going to be a nice little ball with some rock music. Absolutely is going to be at Chris at the Badlander tomorrow night. Ivo presents the Snow Pants No Pants Party at Monk's. I'm definitely not going to that one. Sorry. I'm sorry. It sounds just like no pants. I'm sorry. I'm just not into that. Maybe wear shorts, even though it's Missoula. Most people wear shirts during the winter and, like, sweaters. All right. I'm going off topic. Choir Boy Fantasy Suite Melon Painting will be at VFW. It's going to be a rock tomorrow night. Band in Motion is going to be at the Union Club tomorrow night, which wraps up all your music events that are happening. I do have a Sunday event for you guys. This is the Winterfest 2017, and it's going to be at Lolo Hot Springs, and they're going to start Sunday at 9 a.m. They're going to have snowmobiles, winter ski-joring, Solomon Giant Slalom and Cloverfield races, clover leaf races, and new sleds, all sorts of cool winter activities and cool things. Just kind of, it's basically a whole bunch of people like showing off their winter gear and winter rigs and whatnot. Russian Ark is going to be playing at the Roxy Theater at 7 p.m. on Sunday night. Told in one fluid shot, a tale which floats like a dreamlike journey through a space of the majestic Hermitage in St. Petersburg, Russia, engaging real and imaginative characters from Russia and European history. The nameless protagonist, a 19th century French diplomat, guides the audience through a lost, symphonious dream meant to be considered and expressed as the Enlightened period. The film, staged among some of the masterpieces of Western art tradition, climaxes in a pageant of color, motion, and music. And you guys can check that out at the Roxy at 7 p.m. tomorrow night. It's called The Russian Ark. It's not tomorrow night. It's Sunday night. My bad. But now I have the premiere of another original video made by kids about Donald Trump. And here is Trumptastic.
I'm tired of this complaining about Trump.
I know, right?
It goes on and on. And who are you?
You can call me Trump Jr.
Shut up.
Hey, give him some personal space, Trump Jr.
Talk to personal space?
Yeah, get off my grill.
Flip patties and make shish kebabs on your grill.
You're looking for trouble.
I am trouble.
Stop, guys, that's a really weird fight.
You're a weird fight.
You're a weird fight. Can't stand Trump. He's such like a self-obsessive just person. He makes these points that are so just not.
Are you ready for the Trump?
What are you doing?
He's not making America great again.
He's making America grapes again.
You'll never understand Trump. Oh, freaking out. Oh, God.
He can't walk. He just uses that hoverboard everywhere.
That's just so lazy.
He can't. He's too rich. He doesn't exercise.
Yeah.
He's really just a...
Yeah, life is just so, you know, ow. Oh, jeez. You know, just as I was saying, life is just so hard. God dang it. Stupid hoverboard. Jeez. You know, as I was saying, life is just so hard with me being Trump and a lot of... God. Life is just really hard just being Trump because no one likes me. I wish I had friends.
In your face with a can of mace. I don't like your corn.
It was a hard journey ahead of me, learning to walk. I turned and I fell. I was a sad little boy. It was hard getting up. I tried and I failed. I tried, but I trumped. But just then, I noticed something very disturbing. I found myself surrounded by liberals. I tried to get away fast, but I couldn't use my legs because I depended too much on that hoverboard. Every inch felt like a mile, inching closer and closer to my doom. As I tried harder and harder to get away, it wasn't enough. Oh God, it was getting closer and closer. I was so scared. My life flashed before me as he got closer. As he ran me over, I felt I would never be able to walk again. As I die.
So what do you do with a hoverboard?
And it maybe exploded, but you know, I got rid of it, of course, because it makes sense.
Are you ready for some Trump? It's a toupee, God.
Let's get that freaking Trump, Baker.
right. So that was Trumptastic Adventure, starring the kids from our Saturday morning drop-in animation. You can find out more information by logging on to MCAT.org, but I'm just going to give you more information from the words coming out of my mouth. Here is MCAT.org, and here is our nice little slogan. So if you go to MCAT.org, you'll be bombarded with this picture. Saturday stop animation drop-in for kids age 9 to 13 will be happening, and it's for $10 only, and it goes from 1 to 5 p.m., where we make short videos like you just saw, and we also make some stop animation videos, which I always show for you guys for my Wednesday's stop motion anthology. I kind of make that on my own, but it's also to kind of like entice folks to come on down to check out some of our great software that we use here at MCAT. We use Stop Motion Studio Pro, and also all the videos I've showed you is via this computer, but also using Final Cut Pro as well. You guys can totally find out more information about my show by logging on to wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice, we made you write all that crap. But also you can log on to MCAT.org and be sure to subscribe to us on YouTube and like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. I have a nice little finishing video for you guys, and this is from the rally that MCAT filmed last Sunday, which really hit and talked really a lot about the Affordable Care Act and what a lot of people are trying to do to prevent the repeal of the Affordable Care Act. So if you guys don't want the repeal of the Affordable Care Act, or as the media hilariously calls Obamacare, you guys can call your congressman, call your senator, call your district, state senators, and beyond to talk about how important it is to keep the Affordable Care Act, and how and specifically what they are always looking for are stories and how the Affordable Care Act has helped each person along the way. You can't just say you should keep it. You should also provide a why they should keep it as well. And the better the explanation, the better chance that they use the quote to help engage on some of the opposition side that want to repeal it as well. So without further ado, here is the end of the show. And I just want to thank you all for joining me this Friday, an hour before Trump is inaugurated President of the United States. I don't want to sound too biased, and I don't want to say that my opinions reflect Missoula Community Access Television, Charter Communications, or the city of Missoula. Just letting you guys know what I know, and I'll talk more about what's going on in Missoula and around the area next Wednesday, when we also talk about some other winter recreational activities that will be happening here in Missoula as well. And I'll talk more about this next week. So without further ado, here is a nice little song by Rob Quist. Apparently my dad knows him and went to college with him. So for Wake Up Missoula, I'm Scott Ramph.
If this happens and I go all the way to the halls of Congress, you know, this will be something that I will always do for myself. I just probably won't be performing. But I did write one song I'd like to share with you. And this is the last song I've written. And the idea of the song is that we need to stand up for each other. That's what we do as Montanans. And I know people are hurting. This world can be so cruel. And ugly rumors raging around you. Sometimes you feel just like a fool. But if you stand with me, then I will stand up for you. You are not alone, I want you to know. This world wouldn't be the same without you. And we can never be truly free until we lift all humanity. Don't ever let it get you down when trouble comes around. If you stand with me, then I will stand up for you. And I'll be a strong shoulder to lean on when life seems cold and bare. And every way I will defend you, count on me to be there. And you can stand with me, and I will stand up for you. You are not alone, I want you to know. This world wouldn't be the same without you. And we can never be truly free until we lift all humanity. Don't ever let it get you down when trouble comes around. If you stand with me, then I will stand up for you. Stand with me.